Hello students, today we are going to know about the methods of locating contours, right? So up to last class we know that what is contour, what is mean by contouring, right? So what are the different characteristics of contours, right? So all those things we discussed in the last class, okay? So in the today's class we are going to know about the how the contours are going to marked, right? How the contours are going to plot, right? So what are the different methods, right? How we need to proceed with that, we are going to see, right? So now the methods of locating contours mainly depends upon the instrument, the type of instrument, what type of instrument is going to use. The method is going to depends on the instrument, either it may be tachyometer, either it may be chain, either it may be leveling staff, right? Normally we'll use leveling staff, and some cases we are going to use the tachyometer, right? So next, the field method may be divided into two classes, right? So actually on the field work, right, so we have two methods, that is direct method, another one is indirect method. Okay, direct method means here you are going to use the both level as well as the leveling staff, right, to locate the contour, right? We are going to use level as well as the leveling staff. Here we are going to use the level and leveling staff, level staff, right? Now the contours in this method, what we are going to do now, we will go to the field, right? There we will take the reading, and directly on the ground we are going to plot the contours. Directly on the field itself we are going to plot the contours, right? So here what we told, contour to be plotted is actually traced on the ground, right? We are going to search, right, where contour is located in a given area, right? We are going to fix the level instrument at one particular place, and we are going to shift the level staff so that the every time you are going to get the same value on the leveling staff, same value on the leveling staff, right? So the point where you get same level, that is going to marked, right? So that the thing actually you are going to do with the direct method, right? Level instrument తీసుకొని దాని ఒక ప్లేస్ లో స్టెట్ చేసి level staff ని suppose instantly I am going to get a value of some 100, right? Height of instrument as the 100, okay? So that my instrument is fixed at one place, I saw that is a 100. So now I want to go plot the 100 meters contour, right? So 100 meters contour. Now I can shift my level staff to the another location, then I am going to check whether the same 100 is there or not. If it is not there, we can move to the higher or low based on the value what you get, right? So like that we are going to do, that is the method of direct method of what is called contours, locating the contours. And this method is slow, right? We can't take very much fast. This method is slow and it having some difficulty, okay? Then it is used for only small areas and where great accuracy is required. We are going to use this method for the areas where small area and we need much accuracy, okay? And even though it is also called as tracing out contour, tracing means we are going to find, right? We are going to search, right? We are going to draw there itself, okay? Now the field work is divided into two things. What is vertical control, another one is the horizontal control, right? So in the vertical control, in the vertical control we are going to use level and leveling staff, and we will go to a field. This is the given area, right? Now I am going to set up my instrument here. Okay, now here I have a benchmark. Okay, the benchmark is having a level of 100, okay, 100. Now I am going to shift a point A where I took the level of okay, B, what is called backside plus this thing, no, benchmark, okay. With respect to benchmark, we got 100 point, sorry, 106.5, okay, we won't get that much height. I am going to take it as 102.5, right, 102.5, I got the instrument, I got the value on the staff, okay. Now I am going to shift this staff to the next location where also I am going to get same value as 102.5. If you are not getting this value, you can move up and down, you can move wherever you are getting. Ekkadaithe meeku malli 102.5 ane value malli staff meeda kanipistundo, aa point ekkadundo meer level ni chusukuntu vellochu. Oka suppose ఇక్కడ పెట్టినప్పుడు ఏమో 101 వస్తుంది, ఇక్కడ పెట్టి తగ్గులు పెట్టినప్పుడు దిస్ ఇస్ ఎట్ లోయర్ పాయింట్ అనుకుంటే ఇక్కడ 103 వస్తుంది, 3కి 1కి మధ్యలో కాబట్టి. సో కరెక్ట్గా ఎక్కడ ప్లేస్లో ఉందో మీరు లొకేట్ చేసుకొని ఇక్కడ మార్క్ చేయాలి, సపోజ్ బి. తర్వాత నేను నెక్స్ట్ పాయింట్కి షిఫ్ట్ అయ్యాను, ఓకే. నెక్స్ట్ పాయింట్కి సర్చ్ చేస్తే మళ్ళీ నాకు 102 అనేది ఈ పర్టికులర్ ప్లేస్ దగ్గర వచ్చింది, ఆ పాయింట్ని సిగా గుర్తించుకున్నాను. తర్వాత ఇంకో ప్లేస్లో 102.5 వచ్చింది, దిస్ ఇస్ డి. తర్వాత ఇంకో ప్లేస్లో ఓకే 102.5 ఇట్ ఈ, ఓకే. సో మీరు లెవెలింగ్ స్టాఫ్ని అటు ఇటు కదల్చాలి, రైట్. ఆ పాయింట్ దగ్గరికి వెళ్ళినప్పుడు మార్చుకోవాలి, పొజిషన్ మార్చుకుంటూ ఏ పొజిషన్ దగ్గర అయితే నీకు 102 వస్తుందో అక్కడ మాత్రమే దాన్ని పాయింట్ అవుట్ చేసి ఏబిసిడీలుగా గుర్తించాలి, ఓకే. నౌ ఐఎమ్ గెటింగ్ అనదర్ వాల్యూ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ దట్ ఈస్ 102.5, రైట్. నౌ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు కనెక్ట్ ఆల్ దీస్ పాయింట్స్, రైట్. So this is the contour, this is the contour of 102.5, okay. So this is the method to be used, right, method to be followed in the case of vertical control, right. So the horizontal control will be used when next, once you did this, no, next we have to see the what is the horizontal distance, and again you have to put the instrument here and there in between anywhere, right, to check the correctness of this, okay. So this is the actual method. Whenever they ask, no, you can explain this point, okay. Next, coming to the second thing, right, what is called second method, indirect leveling. Indirect leveling, right. So indirect leveling is going to take the values from the field and we are going to draw the contours on the map, right. So here it includes both field work as well as the office work, right. So in case of direct method, where we are going to establish or we are going to trace out the contours on the field itself, right. Now from by using this method, we are going to take values from the field and then we come to the office and are going to plot the values of contours, right. So now here we are going to locate some guide points on the given area or given location, right. So we are going to take the value or the level at that particular located guide point, right. So those are a system of straight lines and the elevations are found, okay, by locating the things, right. If you are taking a straight line, right, we are going to locate these kind of guide points. This is the guide point, right. So it may be spaced at equal length or different levels, right. So now we will take value of level here and again here, here, right, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, like this we have some points, okay. Each and every point is going to measure for the level and we will note down that values in the field book. After going to the office, we are going to interpolate the contour value, right. We are going to interpolate so that these contours may be drawn in the chart or in a given drawing sheet, right. So now the points then plotted by interpolation, okay. The contour may be drawn on the drawing sheet by the method of interpolation, right. So here we have three methods. One is by using squares, by using cross section method, and using the tachyometric method, right. So first thing is square method. Okay, already I told the same method. I'm going to tell again. On the given flat or given land, you are going to draw the, you are going to form the squares like this. Okay, this method normally used for very small area and wherever the land is somewhat flat, somewhat flat. Okay, now we'll set up the instrument level here, and the first person is going to take the staff person, that is the person who is having the leveling staff, is going to place it over here. First of all, on the benchmark we are going to take the reading, then our survey will be proceed to know the value at this particular point, at this point, this point, this point. Okay, these may be 1 meter or 5 meters. The distance between these things are 5 meters or 1 meter. It need not be necessary that the distance will be the same. Okay, whatever interval you want to put, you can put up to from 1 to 20 meters. You can put based on your accuracy required, right? So now this point, okay, each and every corner point we are going to take the levels. Each and every corner point we are going to take the levels, right? So after noting down all the level points here, now you want to interpolate, right? We will discuss in the next topic how to interpolate this. So here I marked a point. Suppose I got 102 here, 102.6, 101.7, right? This is 103.2, this is 104.2, right? So like that we have the values. Now I want to draw the contour of 102. So it will become here, it may come here, okay? Like this I am going to join by using method of interpolation. Now I can draw the contour on this map. Okay, so this method is called by square method. Okay, next coming to the second method, cross section method, right? So this method is useful for normally railways and highways, normally for railways and highways. Okay, here what you have to do, you have to take cross sections like this, like every point you are going to take the reading level value, right? After taking the level value, right, so you are going to interpret again and you are going to draw the contours by the method of interpolation, right? So then coming to the third method, it is called tachyometric method, right? Here we are going to use a instrument called theodolite. Okay, so it is going to fitted with stadia wires. So in the stadia wires, normally we have a level, we'll have cross hairs like this. Here we have a stadia wires like this, right? Now the value intercepted between these two things, okay, it is going to mark it on the staff, right? So by method of this thing we are going to do this indirecting leveling, right? So next we will see the how we are going to do the interpretation, so interpolation of this what is called contours, right? So here we have three methods. One is estimation, this is very rough survey, and secondly we are having a method called arithmetic calculations, and finally we are having a method called graphical method. Let us see the first method, second method, right? So this is normally a rough estimation, and graphical method, now we are going to use some graphs. Okay, there we can draw the things, and the second one is very, very important, right? Arithmetic calculations. What to do this, we are taking a plot of a b c d, and a point is having a value of 607.4, this is 620,
This is 612.5. This is 604.3.
Okay, these are the level values what we got. Okay, if you are taking a this kind of square, right? Same thing I got here. Okay, now I want to interpolate between these thing. Okay, now I want to interpolate the value of values for 610 and 615. Okay, for meters, everything is in a, we are taking in a meters. Okay, I want to locate these two contours here, right? So now here it is 1 meter. AB AB is 1 meter, BC is 1 meter, CD is 1 meter, AD DA also 1 meter. It is equally spaced, right? So now the vertical distance between A and B, now I want to locate between A and B. So the vertical difference, the vertical difference means 620 minus 607.4, it is going to give the value of 9.9 meters. Now the distance from A, now we are going to calculate the distance from A. Okay, here e madhyalo ekkado a point ekkada untundi edi A level lo unnadi 610 ane value ee rendu madhyalo ekkada untundi kaani A నుంచి ఈ ఎక్కడ ఎంత దూరంలో ఉంది ఈ లైన్ పైన అనేది కనుక్కోవాలి. సో దానికోసం మనం ఏం చేస్తామంటే, సో ఫార్ 610 మీటర్స్ ఆఫ్ కాంటూర్, ఓకే, సో నౌ వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు టెల్ 1 డివైడెడ్ బై 9.9 డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ దీస్ టూ అండ్ okay for 610 meters the vertical difference is 9.9 and here what we are going to take now, so we are going to take the difference between 610 and 607.4, right? So what we will get, 9.9 into here we are going to get a value of 26, that is 0.26 meters we are going it. That means from A, okay, it is located at 0.26 distance, right? So now for 615 it will be find out like this, 9.9 into 615 minus 615 minus what is the thing, 607.4. okay, so finally you are going to get a value of 0.76. that means from A, the another contour is itself of 615 is located at 0.76 we will get. So that is 0.76 meters duramlo A nunchi idi locate ayindi. So ee vidhanga manamu contours aneti gurtistam. Okay, so that's all about for today. So we will discuss other topics in the next class. Okay, thank you.